Welcome to today's session. And in today's class, we will start analog to digital fundamentals or ADC specifications. Then we'll start ADC specifications. So far in the last 4 to 5 classes, we discussed about DAC. So similarly, how we discussed about that, similar way we will study about ADC. We'll start with the specifications. Many things are similar. We'll try to understand the subtle difference between ADC and DAC. And we'll come to the architectures. There are two architectures we have. One is successive approximation, another one is an oversampling. So both we will discuss. So today, let's start with specification of ADC. So before writing any specification, to understand ADC as a box, as a black box, I can write this as my analog to digital converter ADC. So whenever we say analog to digital converter, the input to this block is supposed to be analog signal. So I'll mark this as my input, which is my analog signal. And output is the data, or output is a converter data in the digital format. So since it is digital format, I can actually mark as a digital output bits, which can be represented from D0, D1, up to Dn minus 1. Right, so this can be Dn minus 2. If I mark one more, this is actually a D1. Right, so this is your output digital word. Output digital word. So it is n bit wide. That is why it starts from D0 to Dn minus 1. So this we can identify as the LSB, and this is identified as the MSB of the ADC output or the digital word. Now, as similar to DAC, ADC also need some reference voltage. We call it as VREF. So we will understand the need of this reference voltage shortly when we discuss the ADC architecture, or I can say for this time, all ADCs use some comparators where the input voltage is compared with the reference voltage, and depending on that comparison, your output is generated. So this reference voltage is basically used for comparing your analog voltage with the reference voltage. That is this VREF, right? So ADC, okay. Now when I look at the input to this ADC, input is an analog signal. Input is analog signal. Another thing is when we say analog signal, so if you look at the output, output is discrete. It is having discrete or finite number of values. But if you look at the input side, since it is analog, we have infinite number of values for your input signal. We will understand why I use this word infinite values, because if I draw an analog signal, right, we can actually have n number of values, infinite number of values between in one cycle itself, right? So whenever you have an analog signal, we can say that we have an infinite number of values in that, but when you convert that in a digital format, the values are actually finite, right? So since now we are actually trying to convert from an infinite valued analog signal, this process, analog to digital conversion process, is little more complicated compared to your DAC. In a DAC, you have a reference voltage and you have some digital data. So comparing with the digital, so whatever is the digital data from the reference voltage, we are trying to generate an analog voltage, right? But here it is opposite. We need to convert infinite value data to a finite value data, right? Okay, so okay, now let us understand the very basic thing with respect to ADC. So what was LSB? We defined one LSB for a DAC. For a DAC, what is one LSB? It was VREF, the reference voltage, divided by 2 to the power of n. This was the LSB value. Now, when I write LSB, what we understand from this is actually the smallest possible analog voltage, smallest possible analog voltage at the output. at the output of a DAC. This is one LSB for DAC, right? Now, in a similar way, when I define LSB for an ADC, what is LSB of an ADC? Any idea? Yes.
For zero, like the lowest value of the digital output, what is the corresponding input?
Okay. Yeah. Right. That is correct. That means, see, when you have a three bit DAC, we defined one LSB as step value. I got an answer from Sagar. Yes. So 3-bit DAC, we can write one LSB value as VREF by to the power of n, or we generally write this as VREF by 1 by 8 of VREF. Right. So in the previous examples, we have considered this as with for a reference voltage of 5. So we have taken this as 0.625 voltage. Here one LSB value was 0.625. That means at the output of a DAC, the smallest possible change or the increment value that can happen at the output is actually 0.625. Or if you refer back to the transfer carry of a DAC, this was actually the ideal step height. This was the ideal step height. Here one LSB value was the ideal step height. Right. Now, when I understand LSB with respect to an ADC, it is basically the voltage or the smallest voltage that the ADC must be able to detect. Or I can write in this way, ADC must be able to detect changes in the input signal. So LSB of an ADC is the voltage that detect the changes in the input signal, right? So one LSB for a DAC is 0.625. That means that is the smallest possible change in the output. Similarly, for an ADC, one LSB is, so your output for an ADC will change for each 1/8 changes at the input. So if your input changes by 0.625, definitely that change will be detected by an ADC and a corresponding output signal will be produced. That is LSB for an ADC. Is that clear? ADC will produce digital output for each one LSB change at the input. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So ADC will be able to resolve, or ADC will be able to generate an output voltage for 0.625 volt change in the input side. That is something LSB for an ADC. Now, okay. So one thing is very clear, right? You have an infinite valued analog signal, but your output signal is discrete, or your output signal is finite. So what is inherent with this? When we do such kind of conversion, what is like some inherent things will be attached. What is inherent here?
Error
is very, very, very obvious, right? Because we are converting infinite values to finite values, error is very obvious. Now, generally, we call the output levels of an ADC as quantization levels. Let me write here. Right. You have infinite valued input signal that will be converted into a discrete valued output signal. So those output or the output levels we call as quantization levels. And for an n-bit ADC, how many quantization levels are there?
2 to the power n.
Yeah, 2 to the power of n quantization. These are the various possible combinations at the output, or we call this as quantization levels, which is 2 to the power of n. We'll see this very shortly. Okay. So the fundamental difference of DAC and ADC starts from one LSB definition. So let me define, for a DAC, we define it as one LSB as VREF divided by 2 to the power of n. Here actually we define it as, instead of one LSB, we define it as VLSB. because this shows the a change in the analog input signal. So we call this as VLSV. But again, this is defined as VLF divided by 2 power N. Right. Okay. So one more thing. I'll come back to this. Here I mark this as 1 LSB as ideal step height. Let us see what is ideal, what is 1 LSB or VLSB in your ADC. Okay. So let us look at the transfer care of ADC. Transfer care of ADC. Whoever joins, you should make sure that you'll be in mute. Right. Okay. So coming back. So transfer characteristics of ADC. So in contrast to DAC, for an ADC, we know that so usually we represent input to the x-axis and output at the y-axis. Now, when I write in that form, what is your, let me draw for a 3-bit, let me consider for a 3-bit ADC. So what is our input? Our input is analog input. So analog input. So I mark it as say Vin. And output is a digital output. So output is digital. It is marked as D. Right. Now, your input voltage is actually continuous. It is analog in nature. Now, so your input is continuous. Your x-axis is continuous in nature, and your y-axis is actually discrete in nature. So, can you tell me what will be the output, or what will be the transfer curve for an ADC? If your input is continuous and if your output is digital, what kind of waveform can you expect?
Step curve. Like for this range of voltage, this value of output, digital output, correct. And for the next range of voltage, this one. So it will be a step wise.
Right. Yes, correct. So Sagar asked about something, step value. Isn't this resolution of ADC? I didn't get, you are referring to the 1 LSB value? You're referring to the LSB value. Okay, so we know that resolution and LSB are even in the case of DAC, we define both are same in the sense resolution is always expressed in number of bits, right? So LSB shows the smallest possible change at the output or the smallest possible change that an ADC can detect. But when you write as a resolution, we always define resolution in terms of number of bits. So I showed you how to calculate resolution for a DAC from the LSB value. Similarly, we will do the same thing for an ADC also. I hope it is clear. Okay, all right. Now, so you have actually analog input at the input side. So this can be again defined as Vin, or we can actually normalize this to Vin by VREF. Remember, we have done this for the y-axis for a DAC. Similar way, we can do this. Now, so when I do this normalization, so I can actually write input as 0. Now, this can be written as 1 by 8, 2 by 8. 3 by 8, 4 by 8, 5 by 8, 6 by 8, 7 by 8, and 8 by 8. This is your x-axis. Anyway, your output is actually continuous. Sorry, your input is continuous. But why am I marking here is, so when your input value changes, say your input value is 0, so your output, digital output also should be, the corresponding digital output should be actually 000. right? Cell mark like this. Now, this 1/8 refers to the smallest increment or the detectable change at the input, or this indirectly defines to the LSB. So when this reaches this LSB value, or for one LSB value, what happens? You can actually expect a change at the output. So if this 1/8 is the LSB, then you can expect a change at the output, and that can be marked like this. So corresponding to this is your new data, which is 001, which was 000 initially. Right. Now from 1/8 to 2/8, the output will be in the 001 itself. Now when it again changes the next LSB value, this goes to the next level. So this is 010. Similarly, this will be progressed. Right. I hope you understood this. And so this is your 100, 101. This is your 110. And this is your 111. Right. Now, so one thing I need to understand here is your analog input is actually continuous. So if I want to mark analog input, this is basically your analog input. This dotted line represents the actual analog input. Analog input is actually continuous, right? But for each, your ADC will produce an output for one LSB change at the input, or for that smallest detectable change is actually your one LSB. So in a DAC, we defined LSB as the ideal step height. Now, can you tell me what is 1 LSB in an ADC?
One by eight.
Yeah, it is 1/8. Referring to the transfer CARA, in the DAC, it was step height. Now, what is your 1 LSB?
I didn't understand the questions.
Okay. For a DAC, defined LSB, 1 LSB as the ideal step height.
Yes, sir.
Right, I'll go back to the transfer CARA. So this was a transfer CARA. Somebody gave me the answer. Right. Yeah. So this is a transfer CARA. Now this height was your ideal output increment, was your 1 LSB, right? Because LSB is the smallest possible change at the output. Now, in a similar way, let me look at the chat. Yes, it is step width. Again, Sagar, give me
ideal width.
Yes, ideal width. So ideal step for an ADC, your 1 LSB is actually your ideal step width. Or it is very clear, you can see that this one is your LSB. So each, all these, so for this currently, for this, this graph, what I have drawn is considered as an ideal graph. So this step width represents the LSB change. Right. Now, so if this is clear, as I mentioned before, since I am converting an infinite valued analog signal into the finite valued digital signal, something is inherent. What is inherent? Error is inherent, right? That means, if you look at this graph, for input values from 0 to value less than 1/8, for all these values, we are marking it as 0 itself, right? Even though the voltage is not 0, your input voltage starts from 0. And you can see that here, somewhere in the middle, it is actually 1/16 of VREF. Even that is considered as 0. Similarly, from 1/8, for input voltage from 1/8 to 2/8 of VREF, for this entire range, we consider that as 001 as the next level. That means we anyway know that 1/8 VREF to 2/8 VREF is not same. It is actually a range of analog voltage, but we are considering that as a single digital voltage at the digital value at the output. That means this conversion of analog to digital, or this conversion of infinite valued analog signal to finite valued digital signal, is causing an error, and we call that error as quantization error. Right. So this error is defined as quantization error. So I'll define what is this quantization error. So can we try to plot the quantization error here? So can you try how to plot quantization error? Or what will be the shape of the quantization error if I plot it? So x-axis
you go on this increasing.
Yes. So your x-axis I'll keep as gain by VREF itself. So y-axis, let me mark or let me write this quantization error in terms of LSB. Right. So let us look at this. So these are the changes.
Triangular curve.
Yes. So it starts at zero, right? For your zero, your output is zero. That means there is no error over there. For your input, analog input zero, you are considering output as 0, 0, 0. That means there is no error. But for your analog input of 1/8, what you are considering your output as? Sorry, not 1/8, 1/16. So maybe at this point, your analog input is actually 1/16, but you are considering your output as zero. Right. So that means you can see that from when your input changes from 0 to 1/8, your error is also actually increasing from 0 to that value. That value is nothing but 1 LSB. Are you getting this? Both should be same. I have marked the higher scale. Are you getting this? This is 1 LSB. Now, at 1/8, at 1/8, the value corresponding, the digital value corresponding to 1/8 is 001. That is correct. When I say that is correct, what is the error here? Error is actually 0. But again, from 1/8 to 2/8, again, for the entire range, we are considering the output as 001. That means, again, you have actually an error of 1 LSB. So if I plot this continuously, you can actually get a quantization error curve of something like this, with minimum value 0 LSB and maximum value 1 LSB. Is it clear? Yes, yes. It is something like a RAM function. Yes, you're right. Okay, so this is your, this is the quantity, this is actually, so since the analog input is an infinite valued quantity, and output is a discrete value, the error, the resulting error is known as quantization error. Okay, let me define this quantization. I hope you understood what, how we have drawn this quantization error. Let me define this quantization error. So quantization error is generally defined as QE. So I can write this quantization error as the difference between actual analog input, and the value of the output. When I say output, output in the staircase waveform. We call that a staircase waveform because that looks like a staircase. Right? The output of the ADC looks like a staircase. So these things given in voltage. That means I can define quantization error as actual analog output. So if you look at this graph, your actual analog output is what is marked in red. That is your actual analog output, sorry, analog input. That minus the voltage in the staircase. So how can I write the voltage in the staircase? How will you define voltage in the staircase? If I mark this as V staircase, what is voltage in staircase? How can you represent in general?
That suppose now it's 1, so 1 into the voltage value VLSB. So yes. Next so, 2 means yes. 2.
Correct. That means I can generally write it as V into the voltage LSB, right? Or I will write it here. So V in minus V staircase is actually the quantization error. Now how will I define this V staircase? V staircase is, V staircase varies, but anyway we know that the ideal step with this VLSB, that VLSB multiplied by the digital equal energy output, or this can be further written as V into VREF divided by 2 to the power of n. Right, so that is the V staircase. So D is the value of the digital output code and VLSB is the value of 1 LSB in volts. Right. So by looking at the transfer carry of the ADC, we understand quantization error is something very inherent, and the quantization error value varies from 0 LSB to 1 LSB. So let me bring in a neat graph. I hope you can see this, right? Yeah, this is the graph. The same graph I have drawn there. You can neatly see the analog input, which is represented in dotted lines here. Then the ideal, you can see the staircase waveform, and the ideal step width represents your LSB. And you can see here the quantization error, which is plotted, which is varying from 0 to 1 LSB from this ideal staircase waveform. Right. So now you can see that the quantization error waveform, or the it is a sawtooth waveform basically, that is centered around 0.5 LSB. Right. That graph is actually this, the sawtooth waveform is actually centered around half LSB. But ideally, or for convenient purpose, we generally want to switch, or we generally want to draw this waveform centered around zero, so if I can draw this quantization error waveform centered around zero, so now can you tell me, if I draw this quantization error centered around zero, what will be the maximum and minimum value?
Half LSB and minus half LSB.
Yes. So it will be actually, if I draw with respect in this form, if I draw in with respect to this form, center around zero, your maximum quantization error is 0.5 LSB and minimum is minus 0.5 LSB. So this is a very typical way of defining quantization error, or anything related to ADC or DAC. We generally define as something which is which is within 0.5 LSB. So in order to represent quantization error, the value of quantization error which is within plus or minus 0.5 LSB, we always try to draw the quantization error waveform shifting the centering value from 0.5 to 0. Right. Now if I want to draw this quantization error in this form, what change should I make to this transfer carry?
A half, like zero, instead of 0 to 1/8, when it is in 0, 1/4 only, it should become 0, 0, 1.
1/4 or 1/16?
Ah, sorry, 1/16.
Yes. I don't know how many of you understood. Let me clarify that once again. Yeah, 1/16. Very good. So what I did here is, what you can see now is the transfer carry of a DAC. This is the transfer carry of a DAC, and I have marked the quantization error here. By looking at the quantization error, I understood that quantization error varies from 0 to 1 LSB, and this quantization error graph is centered at 0.5 LSB. Now it is a general like a convenience or a regular practice to draw this graph with respect to zero axis. Now if I want to draw this with respect to zero axis, then the maximum and minimum quantization error, so I know that the maximum quantization error is actually 1 LSB. Now when I change the centering line from 0 to 0.5 to 0, the quantization error varies from plus or minus 0.5 LSB. Now if I want to draw this quantization error in this form, what I should do is, instead of changing this value at 1/8, I have to actually change at this half of this value. Right, if I make the change at half of this value, that is somewhere at 1/16, my this value, my quantization error here will go maximum to 0.5, and from there it will come back to minus 0.5, and then it will actually switch between those two values. Let me explain that with a very neat graph. Maybe with that I can clarify. Yes. So what I will do here is, look at this graph. So what I have done is, I have shifted the entire staircase waveform. The entire staircase waveform is shifted by 0.5 LSP. So that means previously the staircase waveform was about to shift at 1 by 8, but I have done the shifting exactly half of this. Half of this is actually 1 by 16. That means this was shifted towards this side by 0.5 LSP. Now when I did this change, my the transfer error or the quantization error waveform also will change from 0 to 0.5 and minus 0.5. This is actually the variation in the quantization error waveform. Is this clear? The way I shifted and how I have drawn the quantization error waveform. Right. So this shows that the quantization error, is plus or minus half LSB. Right. But now, since I have done this shifting, you can see that the first code transition occurs when the first code transition. So the first code is 000. This changes from 000 to 001 when your input is actually at your Vin by Vref. When it is greater than or equal to 1 by 16, the first code transition happens. Right. So so what is the ideal step bit for this?
1 by 8 only.
Oh, how it is 1 by 8? The ideal step bit is not 1 by 8. No? Here you can see it is again half of that.
But for all the other cases, the width is 1 by 8 only.
Yeah, for all the other cases, it is 1 by 8. Since here we have done this shifting, by 0.5 LSB, the ideal step bit itself to be considered as 1 by 16 or half of the previous. Right. So your digital output corresponding to 000. Is actually half of ideal step width. So I'll mark it as ideal step width. Right. No, I'll write it properly. Ideal step width. Now for all the in-between transition, it is same. All the in-between transition, the step width is actually 1 LSB, but only for the first, it is half LSB. What about the last one? So this is 1 LSB. What about this?
It will go straight there only. Like it will be saturated 1, 1, 1.
Correct. But you can see that the ideal step width is actually more than 1 LSB. Since we have shifted it by 0.5 LSB towards this side, this ideal step width is actually 1.5 LSB. Right. Because the actual value is from 7 by 8 to 8 by 8, it is 1 LSB. Since we shifted by 0.5, this step width is actually 1.5 LSB. But this is actually not a problem since the converter is shifted towards left side. Whenever the voltage comes beyond this value, this will be considered as out of range. The entire converter is actually shifted by 0.5 LSB. So that even though the code width is the step width is 1.5 LSB, this will be considered as out of range once the input reaches somewhere here. Right, are you getting that? You understood that? Okay, so what we have done is we have shifted the entire transfer error by 0.5 LSB towards left side in order to write the quantization error within plus or minus half LSB. When I did that, the ideal step bit for your input digital code for 000 changed from 1 LSB to 0.5 LSB is half of ideal step width. That is one thing. Second thing is the last LSB value changed to 1.5 LSB, but that is still okay because after 7 by 8, this will be considered as out of range. Right. So anyway, it's time up. We'll continue in next class. So can you just tell me what will be DNL or the differential nonlinearity for an ADC? In the case of DAC, your differential nonlinearity was actual step height minus ideal step height. Right. So similarly, here it is actual step width minus ideal step width. Anyway, we will see this in the next class. I hope you understood what we discussed for today's class. We started with ADC specification. We have defined what is LSB for an ADC, which is a change at the input. The ADC will actually produce an output for the smallest change at the input, that is defined as LSB. The transfer care of ADC, quantization error, how to plot quantization error, how to shift the quantization error by towards left to make it centered around zero, and finally the bit code bit for your 000 and for your last bit. Right. So any further doubts? We'll continue the differential nonlinearity, integral nonlinearity in the next class.
Sir, out of range will be from 8 by 8, no sir?
No, not from 8 by 8. It is from almost mid of this. It was actually 8 by 8. Since we shifted towards left, from here onwards, it is out of range. Right. So we will continue this in next class. So thank you so much for attending. Any other doubts can be asked. Okay. Anyway, I'll be uploading this video. Thank you. We'll continue tomorrow.